Hi my dear student, today we will discuss chapter 2 basic algebra exercise 2.9 resolve into partial fractions. Question number 6, we have x minus 1 whole square divided by x cube plus x. In this case the denominator carries x cube plus x. When you factorize, I can write this one as x minus 1 whole square x minus 1 whole square, okay, divided by x cube plus x. Take x common, x into x square plus 1. So I can write this x cube plus x. When you take x as common, it will be x square plus 1 with x. Is it clear? Now I can write this x as, I'll write for x square plus 1 very first. I cannot able to factorize, so I'll replace here ax plus b with the denominator x square plus 1. I cannot able to factorize this quadratic one. I cannot get any real value. So that I'll replace in the numerator as a linear general one, that is general expression, that is ax plus b divided by x square plus 1. For this x, I'll introduce some constant c divided by x. Take LCM, ax plus b into this ax plus c into this x square plus 1. Okay, and here you have x minus 1 whole square by denominator. What is the denominator? X into x square plus 1. That is here x cube plus x. Denominator and denominator get cancelled always. See, very first I have a denominator x cube plus x. When you factorize, I will get x times x square plus 1. So applying partial fraction, for this x square plus 1 I wanted to write ax plus b by x square plus 1. And for this x, I will write some constant c divided by x. After taking LCM, this x times ax plus b plus c times x square plus 1, the product. This is what the same denominator. Denominator, denominator get cancelled always. So finally, I am getting this one considered as 1. Now, I cannot equate with this 1 to 0. I will equate to 0. Put x equal to 0 always, x is 0 only. So put x equal to, when you equate x equal to 0, it gives x equal to 0 only. Put x equal to 0 in 1. See what happened. 0. 0 minus 1, minus 1. What is minus 1 whole square? Plus 1. This is 0. 0 into everything? 0. This is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 into c. It gives c value as 1. Very simple. I will replace x equal to 0 by equating this denominator to 0. So when you put 0 here, 0 minus 1, minus 1. What is minus 1 whole square? Plus 1. When you put 0 here, the entire product will be 0. When you put 0 here, 0 plus 1, 1. 1 into c, c. It gives the value of c as 1. Now, I want to find out the value of a and b. So, what to do? So, as usual, I'll equate the highest power of x coefficient on both sides. So, here when you expand, x square will come. Here, when you multiply this x square will come. Here also, x square will come. I'll equate x square coefficient on both sides from 1. Okay, in 1, I wanted to equate x square coefficient on both sides. When you expand, what is x square coefficient? 1. When you multiply this x here, ax square. So the coefficient of x square is a. When you multiply c inside, x square coefficient is c. What is the value of c? 1. Replace here, it gives a equal to 0. Got it? 1 minus 1. When it comes to the left hand side, 1 minus 1, 0. Therefore, a equal to 0. Now, I want to find out the value of b. In general, I will put x equal to 0. But already, I used x equal to 0 here. Got it? So, I cannot use x equal to 0. I will use x as 1. No problem. Put x equal to 1 in 1. You can give any value. But give a very small value, so easy to calculate. When you replace x equal to 1 in 1, see, what is 1 minus 1? 0. 0 square is 0. When you replace 1 here, no problem. Here 1, so a into 1, a plus b into 1 is a plus b. Replace 1 here, 1 square 1, 1 plus 1, 2. So 2c. Got it? Put x equal to 1 in 1, I'll get 1 minus 1, 0. 0 square is 0. When you replace x equal to 1, it will be a plus b into 1, a plus b. When you replace x equal to 1, 1 square 1, 1 plus 1, 2 with c. I know the value of a, which is 0, see, 0. And c gives 1, so replace here. So b value minus 2. Got it? This plus 2 comes here as minus 2. Now I got the value of A, B, C. Replace here. So therefore I can write x minus 1 whole square by x cube plus x. Okay, this is the given fraction. I can split like this. Okay, replace here. What is A? 0. 0 times x, 0. Leave it. What is B? Minus 2. So minus 2 divided by the denominator x square plus 1. What is C? 1. 1 divided by x. When you take LCM and simplify, you will get the left hand side from the right hand side. Is it clear? Very simple. Very first I factorized and I can split like this. And I am giving x equal to 0, I am getting the value of C. For AX plus B, I want to find out the value of A and B. Here, as usual, I leak the highest power of x, that is x square quotient on both sides, I am getting the value of A as 0. And usually I will put x equal to 0, but already I use x equal to 0. So I cannot give the same value to find the value of B. So I will give some different value like 1, which is a very small value, so easy to calculate. When you replace x equal to 1 with 1, I am getting B equal to minus 2. So I know the value of A, B, C. Replace here. This is what your given fraction. By partial fraction, I split like this. Replace A as 0, 0. B as minus 2. So 0 minus 2, minus 2 by denominator, x square plus 1. C, 1 by x. Is it clear?